Here are 12 new iPhone shortcuts you requested. Get a notification that shows who has a birthday today in your contacts. Create PDFs from your Apple Notes. Create automations based on sound recognition like a door knock. Save YouTube videos to an Apple Note with title, link, and thumbnail. And stay for an advanced time zone shortcut at the end. All right, let's build some shortcuts. First up, someone asked if they can get a notification each morning with their contacts who have a birthday today. So I created this shortcut. It's called Today's Birthdays. It actually searches your entire contacts list and it filters if there is a birthday today. Now that contact card has to have a birthday date in it, so be sure to add birthdays that are important to you in their contacts. If there's multiple, it's going to gather them all in a list and then you'll get a notification. Then you can automate this each morning and get that notification automatically. Depending on how many contacts you have, when you run the shortcut, it might take a second, but then you'll get that notification with whoever's birthday it is today. And if you want that notification automatically happening every morning, go to the Automations tab, plus icon to create a new automation. Let's do at sunrise every day, run immediately, next. Then just search for the Today's Birthday shortcut, and now you'll get a notification each morning with the day's birthdays. Link to download that and all the shortcuts is down in the video description. Next, Amug the Great here on YouTube wanted the phone to go into low power mode whenever he locks the screen. Now you can't create an automation that when phone locks, but you can create a shortcut like this, where it will turn low power mode on and then lock your phone screen. Then you can put this on the action button or a back tap, and when you run the shortcut, your phone will lock and automatically go into low power mode. But how do you get it out of low power mode when you want to use the phone? Unfortunately, you can't trigger automations just by unlocking the phone either. So you'll have to create an automation either when an app is open or closed, maybe an app that you use pretty frequently. If you're not sure what app you use most, I would go to your settings app, and if you have screen time enabled, you can go to screen time, see all apps and website activity, and you can go to first used after pickup. Today's shortcuts is pretty high because I was building some shortcuts before this video, but you can also go to week, and messages is probably a safe bet that you're gonna open that pretty soon after pickup. So what you could do is go back to your shortcuts, automations, plus, and then go down to app. Then when app is opened, choose apps, and you can select multiple apps here, so you can do like messages and mail or and social media network. But when messages is opened, we're gonna run immediately, new blank automation, and we can search for the low power mode action, and we're gonna set low power mode off. Now when we open the messages app, low power mode should automatically disable, and sure enough it did. Now you can also customize this further, like only if battery is above a certain percentage. For instance, let's get battery level, that's a built-in action here. Then you could say if battery is less than, and maybe you wanna do something like 30%, and I'm gonna drag the action for low power mode in the otherwise. So now when you open the messages app, if battery level is less than 30, it's not gonna do anything, meaning low power mode will stay enabled. Otherwise, so if battery is above 30%, it'll turn low power mode off automatically. So that's a way to use a shortcut to lock and enable low power mode, and then another automation to disable low power mode. Next, my wife had to make multiple PDFs that she was going to use on her iPad and Apple Pencil to fill out. Well, she wanted to create a bunch of PDF files, numbered, and you can actually do this with shortcuts. So what I have up top here is a way to number the files sequentially, and then the repeat is however many PDFs you need. Let's turn this down and maybe just create 5. Then I actually have a text block here, which is HTML. I found this to be the most reliable when converting to rich text. So you can adjust that HTML text block however you want. I make rich text from that HTML, then I make a PDF from that. Then I'll save the PDF to the downloads folder of my device. Then it's going to rename each file family interview and then a sequential number name. Now you can change family interview and it'll change what the file name is, and it's going to add the number after each one. So if I run this shortcut, it's automatically going to create multiple PDFs and it's already done. If I go over to the files app, you'll see those PDFs were created sequentially 1 through 5. And if I go into the PDF, you'll see there's places to write and it has it formatted from that HTML. And then you can move these into GoodNotes or Notability for actually marking up with an Apple Pencil. One other PDF shortcut, Jerome in a YouTube comment wanted to be able to make PDFs from Apple Notes. Well, this is pretty simple. I made this shortcut able to run from the share sheet when you're looking at a note. It will make a PDF from that note, and then it will save that to your files. It will also rename it whatever the title is for the note. So you can download this shortcut with the link below, and let me show you what it looks like when you run it. Here's a note I was working on to save some YouTube videos. This shortcut's coming in a second. I can hit the share button here, go down to save note as PDF. And when I run this, it's gonna create that file. It's asking me where to save it. Now you can hard code a folder if you don't wanna have to choose that every time. And now I have a PDF of that note right here, and it even included any images you might have as well. Number 5, you can actually create automations based on sound recognition. Now this is actually part of the accessibility features, but once you have it set up, you can hit the plus icon, and then you'll see sound recognition down here, and this can include several things like baby crying or door knocking. Now if it's grayed out like this, tap open settings, and that's going to send you over to accessibility, where you do need to enable sound recognition. Now when you do this, your microphone is going to be on pretty much all the time. You might get a hit on battery life, so just keep that in mind. But when it comes to sounds, now you can choose what sounds you want to recognize. Now, you actually don't have to do anything here. As long as sound recognition is toggled on, now the shortcut will be able to listen for it. So now we can choose a sound for something like a cough or a door knocking or even glass breaking. Let's do a door knock. I'll hit done. We want this automation to run immediately. I'm actually going to enable notify when run so we can see it in action. Let's do new blank automation. I'm actually going to choose the toggle accessory state. This was new in iOS 18, so I actually don't have to do an if statement or something complicated to just toggle a light on or off. Here I'm going to choose my fill light because we'll be able to see that right off camera. I'll tap done. And now this automation is listening for a sound like a knock on the door. Let's see if it actually works. Oh, you see it actually heard the sound and my light actually toggled off. And remember, you can change it from door knock to any of these, like baby crying, an appliance, tea kettle, and more. Next, I've talked about how I take pictures of physical books, and then when I want to pull information like highlights, it can be difficult. What I do is actually take pictures of the book pages that I want to highlight, but then I just have some random pictures. So what I've done is actually refine this shortcut, where it's going to ask for an album name, and basically for every book that I do this, I name the album the name of the book, like 4,000 Weeks. Then it's going to pull all the images from that album, OCR the text right here in shortcuts, send that request to ChatGPT, although I'm using the Ask AI action because it's just more reliable. Then it's actually going to create a bare note with the content from that book. So if I run this shortcut, it's going to ask. I'm going to type in the photo album name, and that needs to match exactly. It's going to get all the photos from that album. This is going to take a minute because it's OCRing every image. It's going to take all the text that it OCR'd and send that with this prompt to ChatGPT. That'll take another second. Then it's going to create a note with all that information. And that quickly, here's now a bare note. It has main ideas, bullet points, and all the pages that I took pictures of. I actually now have a nice note here with quotes from the book. I find something like this really useful. Next up, iOS 18 removed the ability to choose an album or open an album from shortcuts. And I've done other variations of this in the past, but what this will do is put in the name of an album that you want to select photos from up here. I have an album called Wallpapers, where I keep wallpapers. Then I use the Find Photos action, and it's going to find multiple photos from that album, but I've also filtered it to show the newest first, and I've limited it to 10 items, because if you have a ton of photos in an album, this could take a long time. Then I can choose from the photos, and then at the end of this shortcut, maybe you want to add something like a Set Wallpaper action. Well, you can do that. Set wallpaper photo and then choose the right lock screen, home screen combination. Or maybe I'll just add a share sheet action and then I can share that image however I'd like. So when I run this shortcut, it's going to pull the latest 10 images. These are some wallpapers from Basic Apple Guy, link below. And I can choose one, it'll bring up the share sheet, and then I can do whatever I want with that photo. Next, we had a request from the community to be able to save YouTube videos to notes. This is actually harder than it looks because YouTube doesn't like giving this information easily using the get contents of URL and get name of web page actions. So I'm actually using a service here called NoEmbed. You don't need an API key or anything. This will just run from the link that I have in the video description, but it's going to pull the title, the channel name, the URL, and the thumbnail URL from a YouTube video, and it's going to append it to a note. You'll have to change these last actions here. I called a note YouTube saves, and it's actually going to save the thumbnail and the information about the YouTube video to that note. So customize this if you have a different note you want to use, but you can run this from the share sheet in YouTube. Let's say we're here on my channel here, and I see a video that I want to save, but not add it to my save for later in YouTube list. Well, I'm going to go over to the more option when I tap the share, and I have this shortcut called YouTube video to notes. So when I run this shortcut, it's going to take the YouTube information, append it to that note, and if I go to that note, you'll see it saved the video, here's the thumbnail, the title of the video, the channel it's from, and a link to go watch that video. So now you can have a note or save this somewhere else with an ongoing list of videos you'd like to watch. The actual request for this wanted to save that information to Drafts, so I have another version of that shortcut that saves it to the Drafts app. Along with this though, you might want to get the YouTube thumbnail image. So I have a different shortcut here, which will actually get that image so you can do whatever you want with it. Here on YouTube, I'll tap the three dots, share, go to more, and then use the get YouTube thumbnail shortcut. You'll actually see the thumbnail show up here in quick look. Then I can tap the share button and do whatever I'd like. Number 10 from a YouTube comment here, they wanted a shortcut that closes a Safari tab automatically. Well, there actually is a close tab action you can use. And from here, you can actually ask for what tab you want to close each time, or if you clear that variable, then you can actually choose what tab you'd like to close or tap a specific tab. Now I found it a little easier to just ask each time and then you'll see a list. And when you run it, it'll ask which tab you want to close. Number 11, I get a lot of requests about how do I do an automation that doesn't run on a holiday. So I'm going to create this shortcut from scratch so you can learn how to set it up yourself. But you need a US holiday calendar on your device. That actually comes by default just with iCloud, so you probably already have one. We're going to use the Find Calendar Events, and where it says All Calendar Events, for the start date, let's just say is today, and we're going to pick the US Holidays calendar. Again, you could subscribe to US Holidays calendar like via a public link, and then pull that. And if we run this, I don't think there's any holidays today. Apparently there is one. I don't know what that is, but I guess it's a holiday. So you might need to customize this further, but what I would do next is add an if statement, then tap start date and say calendar event has any value. So if there are any days on that US holidays calendar, and again, maybe find one that just has the main holidays where like you would get off. I'll try to find a link for that and put it in the description so you could subscribe to it. But now you could say if calendar events has any value, don't do anything. So it's not going to run on US holidays. Then otherwise, you could do something like the run shortcut command. And I have things like auto text. And I've actually heard from people that they actually use this auto text group for things like work messages and things like that. And this kind of automation will help it run any day that's not a US holiday. All right, and number 12, this was an advanced shortcut requested by Luisa Chow. And she dropped it in the priority shortcuts request, which that's in my community. And you can join at create.beard.fm. And join over 1,000 people as part of the community. First of all, thank you all so much for actually joining the community. Many of you are actually supporting it. And when you support the community at $5 a month, you get access to the shortcuts request space. And these are the ones I prioritize when I make my shortcuts videos. Now, a lot of you have been asking for some super advanced shortcuts, and I am doing my best to get to them, so stay tuned. But I make sure to answer every request in the shortcuts request folder. Even if it's not possible, I still try and let you know. But when you support the community, you also get access to my Shortcuts GPT. This is one that I've been training on APIs and one that I used to create this next time zone shortcut I'm about to show you. So I would appreciate your support. It's supporting this channel in general. And I have some ideas for other content that I want to offer just for paying members. So you can sign up at create.beard.fm or click the link down in the video description and it'll take you right to the sign up page. And I use my custom GPT to build this next shortcut because Luisa wanted to be able to calculate the time wherever she is that is equivalent to 12 p.m. in Taiwan. Now, there is a convert time zone action here in shortcuts, but it is very limited and it's very difficult to work with your current location. I actually couldn't get it to work at all. So instead, I'm actually using a third-party API from timezonedb.com. Now, the link to this shortcut that I'll put down in the description will include my API key. So if you just want to use it right out of the box, you can do that. If you want to sign up for your own API key, you can do that on their website. It's free to use. Link is below. But what this shortcut does is it will get your current location wherever you are in the world, then takes your latitude and longitude and finds your time zone using that database. And from that, using the dictionary values, I can get the GMT offset. Then I can calculate what UTC would be from 12 p.m. in Taiwan. Now you can also add a second time zone if you want to do more calculations in the moment. Let me know down in the comments or in the community if you'd like that. But Luisa can run this shortcut or create an automation. This way they get a notification every day automatically and it lets them know wherever they are, what is the local time when it's 12 p.m. in Taiwan. So if I run the shortcut, gets my current location, does all the calculations in the background, tells me, well, actually 12 p.m. there is 12 a.m. here where I am. And then that notification will come up and then they can see when they need to start their game streaming. I'll actually remove that quick look right here. And now whenever you run it, you'll just get that notification calculating the time zone in real time. That was a little challenging, and those are super fun to work on. And again, I'm working on several from you that have asked for advanced shortcuts. So stay tuned, get subscribed, and hit that like button. Keep leaving your shortcuts requests in the comments below these videos. I check those too. And if you want to see my last shortcuts video, check it out up here. And I talked about Apple Notes in this video a little bit. That's because I did an entire video talking about 30 plus tips and features just in Apple Notes. It's actually way more powerful than even I realized. Check out that video here, and I have some shortcuts about Notes specifically there as well. Thanks so much for watching and supporting in the community. I'll catch you next time.